The Apple Watch 4 has an exciting new feature. It can detect atrial fibrillation, AFib, with a brand new feature that's part of watchOS 5.1.2. I'm Josh Smith with GuidingMobile.com. I'm gonna show you how to take an ECG on your Apple Watch Series 4. So the first thing that you need to do is go to your Apple Watch, push on the side dial here, and this will bring up your apps. You're gonna need to look for the ECG app, which is this app right here with a little heart rate indicator. It is different from the heart rate app that you've probably used before. So you're gonna tap on that. You're going to be able to put your finger right here and hold it for 30 seconds. And so you're gonna want to have your arm resting on a table or something like that. And you wanna keep your finger on that digital crown for the whole 30 seconds. Now, the first time that you do this, you're gonna have to set up a few options in the Apple Health app on your iPhone, which you're gonna see on the right side of your screen right now, which is gonna show you the options you go through there. And that's really just filling out a little bit of information about yourself, including your birth date, and if you have AFib already. So here you'll see my sinus rhythm. I have an 86 beat per minute average on my heart rate, and this ECG does not show signs of atrial fibrillation. Now you'll see a warning almost every time that you do this where it says cannot detect signs of a heart attack. So if you're having an emergency medical situation, call 911 or your local emergency services. Don't try and use the Apple Watch to diagnose that. Now, if you're not feeling great, you can add symptoms right now about how you're feeling, and this will all be logged with this ECG. So if you go to a doctor, you're gonna be able to let them know how you were feeling at that specific time. And when you hit save, it's going to save, and then we hit done. So here you can see I have an ECG recording available in my health app. So if I tap on that, it's gonna show me my ECGs that I've taken so far. I've taken two of them. I can see my sinus rhythm, and I can see I have no reports of atrial fibrillation, low and high heart rate, or inconclusive. And so you can see all of that, and you can really take all that information together, and you're gonna be able to share that with your doctor. Now, even if you don't have an Apple Watch 4, you're gonna be able to set up irregular rhythm notifications. And you get a prompt for this as you get started, and basically, it's going to let you know if you have an irregular heartbeat and it's something that maybe you should get checked out. And basically, Apple is going to alert you to this, and then you need to go visit a doctor and seek out more information. Now, there are four really big things to keep in mind as you use the Apple Watch to detect an ECG. You cannot detect heart attacks with this. It is not always looking for AFib, so it might not replace a wearable thing that your doctor might prescribe for that. If you don't feel well and your Apple Watch doesn't detect AFib, you have any of these symptoms, still call your doctor, call emergency services, make sure you take care of yourself. And just because your Apple Watch tells you to do something, don't change your medication or anything like that. The Apple Watch isn't gonna tell you, hey, stop doing this, but just because you see something on your Apple Watch, don't change what you're doing without talking to your medical professional. So that's all there is to taking an ECG on your Apple Watch. Basically, you want to remain as still as possible, and it really helps if you're sitting down and you're having both your arms resting right there. I'm Josh Smith with GottaBeMobile.com. We have a more detailed guide written up over at GottaBeMobile, and we'll have a link down in the description below that will help you see everything that you need to know about this. If you found this video useful, please give us a like on this video. It really helps us out. Leave us a comment and let us know how you found this process works for you, and then also subscribe. That really helps us get our word out to more viewers. Thanks for watching.